Thank you, Madam Chair. Thank you for calling a hearing on water in the West, and thank you to our witnesses to joining us today on World Water Day. We are joining a global conversation on the importance of water for our communities, and the science is abundantly clear that climate is changing and it is affecting our water supply. Winters are warmer and the snowpack is melting sooner. This means less water when we need it most, and we must find consensus-based solutions grounded in the 21st century. The Bureau of Reclamation projects help to support diverse agricultural economies in eastern and central Washington, and we must grow over 300 different commodities. We must make all of these things have the economic opportunity that comes with good water planning. Our agricultural economy production topped $10.6 billion in 2016. We're very proud of that. A well-managed water system also helps us to provide affordable hydro for our communities. And Washington is fortunate that this year's water outlook and snowpack is normal or above normal. I look at this map that we've passed out to our colleagues as well, and the brown areas are the most hard-hit impact projections for this year. I'm relieved to see that the Pacific Northwest doesn't have any of that area this year, but it doesn't mean that I'm any less committed to making sure we continue to move ahead on good water resource management. I think this is all based on Bureau of Reclamation precipitation outlooks, and for the Pacific Northwest, we're expected to be at 104%. We're used to wet in some parts of our state, but all of these things matter as it relates to snowpack. And we can see for the rest of the West, the current snowpack and water forecast is dismal. The Rockies, which feed the Colorado River Basin, and the Sierras in California look particularly dry. Oregon's Governor Brown has already declared a drought through the Klamath Basin with a 40% of expected snowpack. So while we are grateful again for this outlook in my state, the trends show that a good water year may become the exception and not the norm. We remember what a drought looked like in 2015 to our communities, and the science is telling us that climate change is impacting and will continue to impact. A GA report also found that the number and intensities of extreme weather events like drought will increase. This will cost taxpayers more than $1 trillion by 2039. So I believe we must plan and we must prepare. I share the same interests as the sponsors of legislation we are considering, and I'm also looking at legislative ideas for comprehensive approaches that take us more than just to one year, but for many years planning in advance. We must help our communities become resilient in the management of our water resources, especially in light of climate change. And there are provisions in this legislation that the committee has previously considered. Some of those we have opposed, but we look forward to working with our colleagues on water conservation programs like WaterSmart, where we find a comprehensive approach. We must also support collaborative solutions that don't pick winners and losers, and particularly don't end up in court for a decade and a half and then stymie our ability to get some basic things done. This is exactly what we did in the Yakima Basin, a shared solution that benefited the entire ecosystem, and I'm pleased Derek Sanderson is here today to talk about that and other water issues. And again, thank you to our witnesses for being here. Dr. Petty, congratulations on your confirmation and welcome back. We look forward to hearing your testimony. Thank you.